Well, of course, the lot has been done in the past to address the issue, and as we talk, a lot is being done. We have improved in a number of indices, from child mortality and, of course, in terms of malnourishment as well. But there is a lot to be done. And if we just look at an equitable learning opportunities to children, equitable nourishment to children across the country, it is not possible because the gap between the rich and the poor is only increasing. And that's where the role of the corporates come in, where they come in and do charitable activities. They open, collaborate with non-governmental organizations to actually reach out to these areas where children are in worse situations. And we actually looked at a few such institutions right now, some efforts being made in terms of education. We visited some community library where we saw how children who do not have access to books, who do not have access to reading, are being given this opportunity by this small library, not very far away from here in the capital. And we found out that children, it is actually making a lot of impact on children. They are learning, they are actually doing a lot of things. So let's have a look at this report and see how these little projects are helping children in this country. The world of books has transformed Divya Singh into a responsible girl. She has been coming to this library for 2 years and has read about 180 books. Her favorite author is Ruskin Bond. This free library is a part of the community library project that enables her to access all kinds of books in different languages. It is in this space in the satellite town of Gurugram she thrives in the world of characters.
I saw that people here are very polite to each other, which is not the case outside the library. So I learned that I can also be polite to others. I read a lot of books, especially fiction. I really liked most of the fiction books I read, and each book transports me to a different world.
This project caters to about 3,500 underprivileged children across 3 libraries, and the 4th is to come up next year. These libraries have been set up in underdeveloped pockets of cities so that children from low-income families can get an atmosphere for learning. The older children who finish reading more books enter the student council. Once in the council, they volunteer in the library for 4 hours a week, looking after the library.
I clean bookshelves and read aloud with the children, and I engage with them. I make them understand that this library is our own and we should all use this space together and be together.
While read aloud sessions and reading books are the main focus of the library, many special interactions are regularly organized for an overall development of children.
We have several workshops, like workshops on gender, workshop on photography camp, workshop on music and association, where they can understand, or maybe they can learn different aspects and different perspective of society, our diversity within our society, and how to engage with them, how to form your perspective.
In the last 2 years, this library has become a positive space for these children, where they can freely think and spread their wings to fly. So you see, this is just a drop in the ocean. This is just a small effort where in this country there are children who don't even get 2 square meals in a day. This is something which is happening near the capital. So the situation is grim, and actually eradicating poverty, or actually decreasing the percentage of poverty, is going to be one of the biggest challenges for this government, especially when the economy is now slowing down. How will corporates chip in? How will governments collaborate with corporates to actually help the last person in the queue to get all the facilities that he or she is constitutionally, you know, it's their right? Back to you.
And there is definitely much more that we can do. Thank you for all those information, Ravinda, about our life for us in New Delhi.